raspberry iced tea. Risk. They didn't have the Arizona tea I normally get, but.
That'll do.
Stuff. Yep. Only $2 too. I keep thinking every time. I don't do this quite as much now, but before, every time I got a bag, I was like, sweet, a bag.
A bag for my trash.
Yeah. Hey, your trash, you can put food in it, you can put, I would like see a bag on the side of the road. I'm like, ooh, I might need that. I stopped doing that. I did find this.
You stopped doing it.
Yeah, I got too many bags. I was carrying.
You got
like
too many. Yeah. No, I've been there and done that and said, boy, I'm going to need this bag.
Yeah.
So what do you got?
Baltimore Ravens.
Just now you pick it up?
Well, it was in the middle of the road. And yeah, last night it was 34 degrees or something. It's going to get down to 28. So now I figure once I get to San Francisco, I'll give that to like Goodwill or something. Just carry it around for the next couple days. These bungee, both these bungee cords I found too.
Doesn't it make your trip so much nicer when you can use things?
Oh, it's the little things. See, the bungee cord, it was actually, I've been okay with 1 gallon. For a little while, I had 2 gallons back here. And
definitely,
I was definitely. Like, I was like, man, I wish I had like a bungee cord or something. Because I'll strap this through, but I have this just in case it comes undone so I don't lose all my water. And I was just thinking, I said, man, if I just had another bungee cord or something, and not 10 minutes later, that red one was right on the side of the road. I said, perfect.
Makes you wonder if your guardian angel or something isn't, yeah. Thank you, right there. Wow.
I found, well, that's another thing about the trip. It's funny, I keep trying to like sum up the different lessons or different things I've kind of learned or observed or whatever in something really concise, and I feel like there's so much and it's so nuanced that it's hard to really get that all down. That's the kind of thing I'd like to sit down after and just write as much as I can, just write, put words down on the paper, and then try to edit down and kind of figure out my thoughts. Because, well, one thing was that it seemed like every time something I was hoping that something awesome was going to happen and it fell through, something else better happened. And it got to the point, it was so consistent to whenever I had something that fell through, I thought like, oh, well, in a day or two, that means something even better is going to happen. So I started looking forward to the good thing that was going to happen because I missed another good thing, you know? I feel like as long as I think it's just a state of mind if you just open yourself up to letting good stuff like that happen, you know, you're going to be able to jump on whatever next thing is coming your way. Kind of, as long as you're going with the flow.
And
it seems like you're just getting lucky, but really it's like all around, you just got to open yourself up to it.
And Ben is not an opportunist, folks. He turned down that bicycle lady offered him.
Oh, yeah.
And figuring that, yes, his was totaled, but it still rode. So it wouldn't be right for him to take a bike that he didn't absolutely need.
Yep. Mostly over the climbs. I didn't realize Nevada was going to be so, like, mountain after mountain after mountain.
More mountains in Nevada than any other state. That's what Nevada brags. And not all of them are real big, but there's a lot of them, and it is pretty to drive, especially in the winter. They all get little snow on them, and it's real pretty country.
Because so many people tell me, like, oh, you got to check this out when you're in Nevada. You got to go on this trail when you're over in California, and if I don't write it down, you know, it's gone.
And so, Ben, your bicycle was totaled.
That's what they said. That's what people kept telling me. But it's holding up okay. This, both seat stays, actually, I had to get those welded in St. Louis. And when I got hit, the welds both held. So I'd like to contact the guys at the welding shop and let them know that they did a damn good job.
They'd like to hear it. Yeah. Wow. So, but now, was that the same garage that bent your
No, that was
lever,
another. That was another
crank
one.
Lever.
That was some other friendly people. They weren't too confident. He didn't know if he could do anything to help me, and then he did like just an excellent, excellent job.
That was in a little town in Kansas. Kansas.
Yeah. Yeah, the guys that bent the bike back, so it's rideable. It's taken me almost 2,000 miles since then. Some guys at the tire shop, I guess. Like, I actually camped right by the tire shop the night before, so I showed up to pick the bike up, and they were like, "Yeah, we saw you camping out there."
That sprocket, that crank lever right there was all bent, yep. And they put it in a vise and bent it back for you.
Yeah, and I kept meeting people at bike shops that said they took a look at it, and he said, "I don't think we can do anything for you." And he was like, "I can sell you this bike for $100."
Oh, yeah.
And then the thought of just leaving this bike in Kansas somewhere, though, I told him, I was like, "I can't do it, man. I'm sorry. Too much sentimental value."
So you were hit by a car and had how many stitches?
I had 11.
It's not funny, but...
Five inside there. Four right under my lip, and then two down there.
And your bike was totaled.
Yep.
Except for a mechanic shop went ahead and bent the supposedly unrepairable crank lever for you. A welding shop welded what for you? What was it?
These seat stays right here. I was, because I pick up my bike, I'll pick it up like this. And one day I picked it up and both of those were detached from it. And I said, "Whoa." So yeah, they welded that back for me. Yeah, this is the bike is the product of a lot of people helping me out. The whole trip is a product of a lot of people helping me out. There's been a lot of generous folks I met. Again, that one dude in Utah saying I was too trusting, whatever. I'm trying to think of like bad experiences I've had. And besides, the only bad experiences, besides, you know, crappy weather or something. I mean, and then those that make good memories anyway. Like, pretty much all the people I've met have been awesome.
And where did you start? Where did your trek begin? And did you know you were going to cross the country when you started?
I started in Richmond, Virginia, back where I grew up. I just started riding my bike again, 3 years ago or something. And I hadn't ridden in years and years. Me and my roommate in college did a 120-mile trip from Harrisonburg to Richmond, just decided to go for it.
Harrisonburg, down where the university is, right? Or
yeah, that's where I went to school, up in Harrisonburg, Virginia, James Madison University.
Yes, James Madison, yeah. So you knew you still had it.
Yeah, yeah, I started doing like weekend trips, and then, me and some friends, we have my friend Dylan, who's over in Australia right now, he's been living there for like a year. We would do a couple trips over near the ocean. We went down to Williamsburg a couple times. I got in my head, I was like, all right, one day I've got to do coast to coast. I got to set out for a long time. And that came a lot sooner than I thought. Graduated college, I was like, all right, yeah, why not? Just go for it.
This year?
December, yeah, I graduated. I was kind of hanging around. I didn't really know what I was doing with myself this spring. I was just kind of waiting for the trip, you know? I would camp behind churches a lot.
Churches?
A lot of time I'd roll in late at night, so I didn't get to talk to anybody there. But generally, if people found me camping in the morning, they would offer me, you know, if I needed to come inside, fill my water bottles up. Nobody was ever mad at me for camping, you know? I figure it'd be strange for somebody to find you camping at a church and be like, "What the hell are you doing? Get out of here," you know?
You regularly bicycled at night?
You know what? I'm not the most timely person in the world, so today it's like 2 p.m. already. Because a lot of folks I know get up at like right before dawn and start going. I'm no good at that, so I'll always be maybe 10, 20 miles short of where I need to be. The sun goes down, and you know, I wouldn't bike a whole lot at night, but I'd end my days a lot.
Yeah.
You know, doing a little bit after dark.
Yeah.
I mean, I got the lights and everything, yeah. So.
Yeah. Well,
I feel like I'm even a little more visible after dark. Like, supposedly you can see that from a mile away, and I got two big old reflectors on the back of here, so
left home 4 months?
Four and a half now.
Four and a half months ago. And here he is in the middle of nowhere, Ely, Nevada. And
it's the most civilization I've seen for a couple days now.
Now, will you be taken? Yeah. Which is works to my benefit because, you know, you don't mind talking. You haven't talked to anybody in a couple days. But you're going to take the loneliest highway in the road, Route 50?
Yeah, it's been pretty peaceful, actually. I prefer the word peaceful, I think. I know they say lonely. I thought it was going to be lonely, too, but it's been kind of nice, actually. Been keeping myself busy. I've been listening to music a lot when I bike, and I've listened to all the songs. I've only got a couple albums on my phone that I listen to, and I've listened to them all through a couple times, and now I'll just, you know, try to read some good articles or something before I go, and then I'll just like let my thoughts work while I'm biking. Get some. That's a little more interesting than listening to the same album over and over.
Major in college. Majored in what?
Graphic design.
Graphic design.
Yeah, and I do web design stuff now. I've actually been. This is one thing that's been kind of interesting about the trip. I've been working and traveling. Like when I left, I had like $60. Because I was gonna save up like $3,000 or $4,000, you know. Of course, that didn't happen. So, but I figured I got my laptop. I can just kind of keep working as I'm going.
Oh, all right, on your laptop.
Yeah, and the toughest thing was that's by far the toughest thing. Not going over like 10,000 foot passes or anything, but managing working and traveling, getting a lot of stuff in balance. I guess working, traveling on the bike, enjoying where you are. You know, and sleeping enough so that you have like energy. Because I thought of that, I was like, maybe if I only sleep like 3 or 4 hours a night, I can get all this stuff in. But yeah, I still haven't quite figured out the right balance. So that's been the toughest thing, I think. I was lucky that, you know, I've got that kind of setup where I can work from my laptop and be able to afford to travel like this, but. In the future, I think definitely I'd rather work a lot and then just like kind of disappear for a little while, you know? I got like a fancy camera sitting back at home that I just, it's got its own separate case and everything, you know? And it just stays in my closet just because I end up taking pictures on my phone a lot more. The quality's not going to be there. You don't have as
but
much
But you get
control,
the pictures because but,
it's right there.
Camera's right there, yeah.
And I can upload them. I've been posting so many pictures rather than I thought I was going to be writing blog posts and everything, but it's different to sit down for an hour and like hammer out all your thoughts than just in that moment you take the picture, then just bam, and all of a sudden it's up online. It's all automatic, you know?
You're connected.
Yeah, so because of that, I end up, you know, that's the route I end up using to share stuff because it's so lightweight. I mean, I've met some folks that there's one guy that was couch surfing. You know couch surfing? Oh man, okay, well that's a whole separate thing. Couch surfing, it's like a hospitality exchange for travelers. It's this network. It's couchsurfing.org, and you search for a city and you look for people that'll host you there, and you go in, sleep on your couch.
I've heard of it. Yeah.
Yeah, both sides of it are pretty awesome. Staying with folks and having folks come stay with you. So,
Dan, it's really good talking to you.
Yeah.
I wonder if I have. See, if I was on top of things here, I'd have one last question for you, but I don't. But. Man, you're going to be on your way. When are you going to be on your way now? You're going to hit the road tomorrow then?
I think I'm going to head down the road a little bit today, actually. I mean, I got 4 hours till the sun sets. So, you know, part of me is thinking that's only 4 hours. But then again, that's like 30, 40 miles. Like, I'm going to camp out somewhere anyway. Might as well get down the road.
All right. Hey, I appreciate talking. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, it was nice talking to you too. All right.